So here we are, March 7th, 2013, and I'm working on Thor, the four-core whore. It's a MacPro 1.1, the original MacPro system, and in a million years, I never thought I'd be opening this effing machine up again and screwing around inside, but indeed there is some type of a crash. Here's the insert clip showing Thor, the four-core whore, with a total freaking lockup and the screen totally blitzing out. I am absolutely jumping the gun, making an assumption that the problem is with the video card. The video card failed, because I did run some RAM tests and the RAM said it was okay. And I don't know, when I'm like, you know, going through any graphics or screensaver kicks in or something relating to the video card, the thing locks up, it crashes, oh well. Let me show you my cable mismanagement system for Thor, the four-core whore. There you go. And my friend Kyle promised to freaking clean up this mess since 2009. Yeah, Kyle, I'm waiting for you still, okay? All right? Yes. I didn't forget. Wow, this place is a freaking mess. For those of you who don't know, the machine Thor the four-core whore is a production machine. I use it for doing my webcasts, which I haven't done in like several months. And good thing I didn't do one tonight because it would have crashed. Let's see what type of a dirt buildup we have inside this machine that hasn't been opened in years. Overall, with regard to dust, it's not too bad, but it absolutely still does warrant a blowjob. And there you now have the stock blowjob joke that you were all waiting for, and knew, and expected. Okay, and while I am diligently working on Thor, the four-core whore, let me show you what else I'm doing just to, like, make things go even slower, make things go, like, at the pace of a crawl. I'm actually going through my binder of legacy CD-ROMs, and I'm transferring them to the hard drive because, as you know from prior videos, these things decay, especially with the labels. The glue, like, eats through the substrate. So if any of you have, like, old CD-ROMs that have, like, important archival stuff, I definitely, definitely highly suggest
that you do check them out and make sure they're still intact. And if you can, transfer them. I will show you one thing that I've had success with is the early CD-ROMs that were, like, kind of gold. They were, like, gold-plated. These seem to be the most intact out of them all. The materials used in the gold-plated disc seem to have withstood the test of time. A lot of the cheap store-branded blanks that I used, they just, like, flaked off and deteriorated. So do check your CD-ROM archives to ensure the integrity of the data. And if that special CD-ROM with all those wedding photos are gone, they're gone because the freaking material flakes off. And there you have it, that bit of archival news from Alfred at alfred.tv, one of the worst websites on the entire internet. Really, check it out. It sucks. Well, here it is, May 26th, and I'm still working on Thor. When did I start filming this? Like March 7th? Yeah, I tend to get a little backlogged with projects, and it happens in whatever. All right, let's see where we are.
Rolling back the video footage. The machine had indeed gotten a quick blowjob, and we're ready to replace the video card, which I'm assuming is a thing that's damaged. And over here I got this graphics card upgrade. I like that better. What is this piece of shit? This thing I got from Otherworld Scomputing that supposedly works in the MacPro 1.1. It's an ATI Radeon Hood 5770.
Yeah, well, again, I'm assuming the video card's busted, so it's brute force. Let's just freaking replace it. Nice.
So there's the NVIDIA card that I yanked out, and here's the new card that will be thrown in. But let me tell you something.
Yes, to indeed make this video semi-useful, which is absolutely, definitely not my style, when you're yanking out a video card on a Mac Pro, make sure
that you pull this tab a little forward. All right, because if you just yank up on the card and you don't pull this release tab a little forward, you know, reaching underneath the video card, again, and pulling it a little forward, wow, you're gonna, like, have a crack party in your motherboard. Nice.
Well, after much struggling and sweat, predominantly because I forgot to take out one of these freaking things, it needs, like, double slot space, I finally got the board in. Now I'm gonna screw this thing up. Well, I've already done that, but screw up everything. Yeah, I've already done that too. Let me just button it up and turn it on and see if it works.
Okay, boot sequence, new video card. Do we hear the bong? Do we have bongification? Do we hear... There we go.
Over to the cinema display. Do we get bootstrap? Yes. We are booting. Zoidberg, hooray. Of course, I'll have to keep this thing on and let it burn in and see if that... If it fails again, because it might not be the video card. Like I said, brute force repair. Screw it, just change the video card. Booting into OS 10.4 Leopard. I'm kidding. No, it's Tiger. No, yeah, I screwed up. Yeah, I meant to say booting into OS 10.4 Tiger.
Yes, I'm really very knowledgeable about this crap.
We have the blue screen of death, but that's just a precursor to hopefully a desktop. What's the definition of precursor? Fuck you. There you go. And we do have a desktop. Another Zoidberg horror.
What does it mean? Maybe you'll see a live Alfred.tv webcast really soon. Horror. You know, I might even throw a few more upgrades in there. Like this Samsung Susud. I don't know. Let's make the machine unstable by throwing multiple upgrades at the same time so I can't isolate where the point of failure is. That's the way we do things here at Alfred.tv. We do them incorrectly.
It's now time for the official opening of the box of the Intel Xeon Quad Xeon Performance Mac Pro. And there it is. With a cheese grater in the front. That is kind of funny. Ow, like I'm hurting my finger with that thing. It's very sharp. Very cool. And Adam, with the official shiv, will now open the box.
The box is now about to be opened.
Here it is, folks. History in the making.
I would like to say, before I complete opening this box, that it's a pleasure to open this box. And I hope to open many more boxes in the future. And now back to opening this box.
Get on with it! Is that it, eh?
So far. And now, the opening of the lid. Well, the flaps. Designed by Apple in California.
But made in China.
Built in China. Built in China by, well, people with jobs.
Steve Jobs.
The keyboard in its especially large keyboard holder.
Nice.
It's padded for your protection.
Very good.
And here it is. Wow.
World of Warcraft? That was a wow
joke.
No.
Worlds of Wonder.
Nice.
Because it's just going to be a wonder if I can lift this thing.
Okay, I'm going to put the camera down.
No, you're not, actually. I was wrong. It's quite heavy.
Nice.
But I can still handle it.
Adam,
I think that helped my back, actually.
You have to do the music like you did for the G5 opening.
I was standing where you are for that, but okay. Wa-da-da-da.
There it is, folks.
That's exactly what I did last time.
It looks like the same bloody machine. Matter of fact, Adam, if I wasn't looking, you could swap that for the G5, and I might not notice.
True.
And if I see you walking over a large 80-pound silver box, I say something's up.
Yeah, but you'd be able to catch me real easily.
That's true.
That's true.
Let's see what's going on inside.
What? Nothing's going on inside. We're in here.
Knock it off. How many days since we started this project?
Three.
3 days later, we're finally ready to power up the Mac Pro. All right? Right now, we have...
I'm sorry, it's 4 days.
All right, the G5 is up on the DVIL DL switcher on the 30-inch... fat bastard cinema display, and there it is, waiting for the power switch to be turned on by Adam, the Mac Pro.
I know I'm a Mac Pro, but so is that.
Knock it off. Switch the switcher. And we're now ready. This is it, folks. This is what we've been waiting for.
I won't even tell you how much this whole thing costs. Oh, my God.
Given our history with this type of event, I wouldn't expect much right now. Okay, it's kind of quiet, but hey!
There it is! It's booting?
It's booting! Screen's lit. On side two.
There's the apple. We do have the apple. It is booting, folks. This is just unbelievable. Wow, it's taking a long time. This is not impressive.
No, it's not. It's his first boot. So, yes, it's going to take a little while.
It's probably seen all those drives and going, blah! Where the hell did these come from? They're not from the manufacturer. There we go. First boot. And she's up.
Okay, use Swedish for the main language.
That's like Swedish porn. No, knock it off. Go to English, dummy. English. Wow, what if you said English? Wait, you should have went down and scrolled to the other languages. You would have said. You blew it.
Welcome. Welcomen. Welcome. Turn the bola. Mm. Bienvenue. Welcomen. Benvenuto. Benvenido. Benvenido. Squark. Falcomen. Schnee. Kaikwone. Gang. Twinleven.
And here's the irony. And the irony of this whole thing. All right. Why? Why did I get this system? Hang on. There's a reason. So I can run PC games like Fear. I can't wait to put Windows XP on this new system.
No! It's going to be terrific.
Yes,
no!
I am. I'm going to do it.
No!
Yes, I'm going to do it.
No! No, you're not putting that on. You're not using that.
Damn.
No, you're not.
It's good. That's
no.
The way, that's the way it's going to end. No. It's going to fade out to that.
No!
It's good. Say goodbye.
Bye.
Well, we just got off the Hulk. And the Hulk has a little bit of a surprise, which is high-speed acceleration. Ben, how'd you do?
At the I was a little unprepared, but we got through it with flying green colors.
Did you feel the balls in your mouth?
They stopped at my chest. I kind of muscled them back down, but
what about my balls?
They kind of, I don't know. They
in your mouth. It was a bad joke. Sorry.
Welcome to Alfred.TV.